Greetings to our viewing audience. This is Miko Evans, and you're tuned in to the 15th anniversary episode of Meak Pro Media Special Edition News. Happy anniversary. To our viewing audience, and happy fall season. This is the 15th anniversary episode of Meak Pro Media Special Edition News, the official podcast of the world's first LGBTQ exclusive talent agency and production company. We're in our 21st year of operation, but as far as our media podcast show, this is our 15th anniversary season, and we've been having an awesome anniversary season, starting with our preseason from last year, fall of last year, and then all the way up until our official anniversary season. Man, it has been awesome. And thank you so much for supporting like you all always do. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and continue to follow us and check out all of the information that's located at the bottom of your screen. And as you know, I always got to bring special guests and special surprises on our show, because that's what this show is created for, to provide a platform for the unsung heroes and sheroes within the LGBTQ plus community globally. And I am so happy to have for the first time on our show one of the representatives from the Atlanta Pride Committee. And they're getting ready to have their annual Atlanta Pride Festival this coming weekend, which is going to be, make sure I get the date set, because you know how I am, I'm getting old. It's starting Friday night with their annual VIP reception at the Georgia Aquarium. And so that's going to be October the 11th. And of course, they're going to be at Piedmont Park from October the 12th through the 13th. And so be sure to check out all of that information that's located at the bottom of your screen. That's www.atlantapride.org for all of the updated information and all of the detailed event schedule that's going to be going on for this weekend. So happy Pride to everybody that's listening and that's viewing. But let's get on to the conversation I have with me, Brother Stephen IGARASHI-BALL. I hope I said that right. Let me get you unmuted.
IGARASHI-BALL. Yeah, you're right.
Okay, I just want to make sure. Yeah, I wanted to make sure I had that right, because I'm like, wait a minute, did I pronounce that right? What's going on, Stephen? How's it going?
I'm good. How are you? It's so exciting to be here. Thank you for having me. And I feel like this is long overdue, because I see you everywhere. We are always at the same events, and you are out keeping people informed and covering everything that's going on in our city.
Yeah, you know, I try to be everywhere as I can. So, you know, but thank you so much for agreeing to even come on our show, because I've been wanting to do something with Atlanta Pride on our show for the longest. So you find a mate that happens. So thank you so much, brother.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
Let's kind of get into your background a little bit. Tell everybody, first of all, your position with Atlanta Pride first.
Sure. So I am Director of Communications and Community Engagement for the Atlanta Pride Committee. So wear a lot of hats in that role, but basically I'm the one who is leading kind of our storytelling in the community. And not only the story of Atlanta Pride, but the story of our community in a lot of ways. And so that is all of our communications, social media, emails, newsletters, but also working in community engagement. So I get to lead our grant initiative and work with our community partners through that. And then I oversee a lot of the components for the festival every year, from our family fun zone to working with our amazing grand marshals every year, our pride pageant and our pageant winners, and then also getting to work with our show coordinators for both the Shooting Star Cabaret and the Starlight Cabaret. So lots of different roles.
Wow. Tell us a little bit about your background as far as have you been involved with Atlanta Pride for a long time, or is this your first position with Atlanta Pride?
So I came on staff a little over 3 years ago,
Mm-hmm.
and but I am a Georgia native, born and raised. I grew up in Gwinnett County,
Okay.
and so I grew up seeing the festival, attending the festival, and then I've worked in with other community organizations like Aid Atlanta. I was there for 13 years, and so I was an active participant in the marketplace. In the parade. So even though I've only been on staff for 3 years, I feel like I have a much longer history with the organization.
Wow. Let's get into your as we used to say down here in the South, because I'm born and raised in Georgia too, you know. Let's get into your testimony and stuff. How was it for you, being born and raised in the Confederate South? How was it for you coming out, growing up, in your neighborhood?
Yeah, so first I want to say it's funny that you say testimony because I grew up in the church, like so many of us here in the South. My degree is actually in theology, and I worked as a minister as a vocation for about a decade.
Wow.
So that colors a lot of my upbringing, my background. And also my struggle with who I am, as a queer person, as a gay man. and I think that growing up in the South, I feel like the South is very polite, and that there are a lot of things that are tolerated, but a lot of things aren't celebrated.
That part.
And so it's been a journey for me to get to a place where I can fully love and accept myself and all of the pieces that make up who I am as a person. And I really feel like my journey has been leading me to my work with Atlanta Pride, because I feel like I get to show visibility and representation for other people in our community, which I think is critical. and I always think I think that I'm doing work that I wish I had when I was a kid, I didn't grow up seeing a lot of out queer people. And if you did see like media representation, it wasn't positive images. So I feel like now we have an opportunity to change that narrative. And hopefully that is creating a safer space for people who are coming out today. That's kind of my testimony.
You know what? I love the fact that you shared this, because on my show, I always remind our audience that everyone's coming out story or coming into a story is very different and it's very unique according to their upbringing. And before we actually get into what to expect for this coming weekend, tell us a little bit about when was the moment that you decided, look, I'm going to be who I am and forget the rest of you all? Because I know coming into that awareness was kind of difficult as well, like it was for me. So tell us a little bit about that particular moment that you made a conscious decision that I'm going to be all that I know I can be.
So I think I've always been who I am, and my family will tell you that who I am today is who I was as a 5-year-old kid, and I'm a drag performer, I'm an activist, I'm an advocate. And I think to some degree I've always been those things. I'm an effeminate gay man, I'm a fat gay man. And so I am somebody who can't hide who I am. Even when I was technically in the closet, I don't think that I was really like a passable person as far as like straight or heteronormative representation. The process for me has been one of really just learning to love myself, accept all of the pieces that make me who I am, and then amplify that because I want to turn the volume up. I want to break the knob off.
That part.
And I always say that living your most authentic life gives other people permission to live theirs.
Absolutely.
And you don't realize how much other people need that permission. So you may say, there's nothing wrong with me. I love myself. I accept myself. It's not necessarily always about you. It's about giving other people that permission. And when people see you living your queer joy, it gives them the ability to do the same thing.
Well said, well said. How long have you been doing drag?
I have done drag. Well, I always say that I have photos of me. The first time I remember being in drag, I was 6 years old and I was Miss Piggy for Halloween. I still love Miss Piggy, who is a queer icon.
Yes.
And a drag inspiration. So I feel like I've done drag my whole life, but I have done my drag persona is Miss Terracotta Sugar Baker. I have done that for, I guess, since 2007.
Wow.
So almost 20 years. And I had a Drag Story Hour Atlanta, and we just celebrated our 7 year anniversary of doing Drag Story Hour here in the community.
Wow, that's awesome. That is so awesome. Before we actually get into all of the meat and the grease as far as what's going to be happening for this upcoming weekend, we're going to take our only commercial break. And during this commercial break, you're going to see snippets of Meak Productions' participation in the Atlanta Pride Parade in previous years. We're going to kind of give you a throwback, a trip back down memory lane. And plus, you're going to see the current commercial for Atlanta Pride and stuff, as well as others. So please stay tuned. We have more with our brother Stephen Ball right here on the 15th anniversary episode of Meak Pro Media Special Edition News.
Happy Pride, everybody! Productions in the house! Yeah!
Productions in the house!
Yeah!
Yeah!
New recruits! New recruits! New recruits!
Come on, boys!
Yes!
So we're coming to on stage. Oh, thanks. My dad can have all the legs called the
I think that's like
I'm not receiving blessings. Your eyes are window to your soul. We all receive you stressing. That last email received was all I needed to keep my
tuned in to Meak Productions syndicated shows. Don't go anywhere. We do have more in store.
Thank you.
there, this is George Carlton, president of the Metro Atlanta Association of Professionals. Are you looking to expand your business, seeking employment connections, or want to grow your professional network but don't love traditional networking? The MAP is right for you. As Atlanta's first LGBTQ plus business association, we pioneered partnerships and networking with Atlanta's leading changemakers to help you connect authentically, in person and online, with people from diverse industries, identities, and histories. For more information about membership and being part of our legacy, visit our website at www.maapatl.org. Once again, that's mapatl.org. We look forward to connecting with you real soon.
Meak Productions is proud to be an official media partner for this organization.
Hello, everyone. This is Chris Lugo, Executive Director of the Out Georgia Business Alliance, Georgia's only chamber of commerce serving the LGBTQ plus community and our allies. Formerly known as the Atlanta Gay and Lesbian Chamber of Commerce, Out Georgia serves the community by advocating for the most inclusive and equitable business environment, providing support and resources to fuel economic growth, and driving meaningful community connections and impact across the state of Georgia. For more information about membership and the legacy of our organization, please visit outgeorgia.org. Once again, that is outgeorgia.org. We look forward to serving and networking with you soon.
Meak Productions is proud to be an official media partner for this organization. And we're back with the last half of our official 15th anniversary episode of Meak Pro Media Special Edition News. Of course, this is your host, founder and executive producer, Miko Evans. And I'm still here with Brother Stephen Ball, who's has been with the Atlanta Pride Committee for how long now?
3 years.
For 3 years in his official position. And so we just had a wonderful testimony service, as we call it. Of Stephen actually telling his story and stuff. And thank you so much for sharing. So let's continue on with the spirit of pride. Give our audience a sneak peek of what to expect for this year's Atlanta Pride Festival.
Well, the first thing that I want to say is our theme for this year. So you can see in my shirt and in my background, our theme for this year is United with Pride. And I think that this really kind of captures the moment of where we are as a community, as a nation. You know, this year is an election year, and there is a lot of impact with that, especially here in Georgia. We know that our state could very well be the deciding vote in who is going to be our next president. Mm-hmm. And so I think that our theme for this year is really about capturing the spirit of solidarity and empowerment within our community. It's a call for us to really come together in supporting each other, but also recognizing the power that we have in that unity. So I'm excited for that. And I hope that that really resonates with people. As they're at the festival. I also want to just say that, you know, there's a few things I think that people don't realize about our festival. Our festival is the largest free Pride event in the country.
Wow.
And the only reason that we are able to be a free Pride event is because of the support that we get from the community. So I hope that people will recognize that and that they will come out and they will support the vendors at Pride. The funds that are raised through our festival help support the work that we do 365 days out of the year. And awesome. Some people may not realize that we do work 365 days out of the year. But we host events throughout the year. We have community partnerships. And of particular interest, I think, is our Pride Across the Peach State grant initiative, which was new this year. We've done community investment grants for a number of years, but this year we decided to shift the way those funds were spent. And our Pride Across the Peach State grant initiative supports other local Pride organizations all across our state.
Wow.
So we have recipients who are in Savannah, Rome, Macon, Carrollton. We just had Carrollton Pride just recently. Statesboro just had their Pride last weekend, as well as supporting organizations like our friends at Out on Film. And this year we were able to award 13 grants to the amount of $50,000.
Wow.
And to our knowledge, we are the only Pride organization that is doing that kind of community reinvestment work at that level.
That's the, I think, the most beautiful thing about your organization, because I remember there was a time when you all didn't just started and you all were still growing, and the only thing that you all had resources to do was just the Pride Festival every year. So to see the evolution of Atlanta Pride over so many courses of the years and stuff is just so beautiful and so remarkable and stuff. So kudos to that for you all doing that. And of course, if anybody wants to find out more about how they can apply for you all's grant, they can just go to the website, correct?
Yes. So our grant cycle for this year is closed, but it will reopen sometime in early spring. And there are details about that on our website.
Gotcha. Tell us a little bit about some of the main star performers that's going to be featured on the main stage this year.
Yes, we always have a hot lineup, and I think that this year is no exception. So our headliner is Ava Max, who the community response for that has been really exciting.
Wow.
And I think that people are really going to enjoy their performance. We're also excited that Monet Exchange from RuPaul's Drag Race will be performing Cakes Tequila, and Mila Jam, who is a trans performer, and I'm super excited to see their performance. They have a song that I really love that is a an update of the classic "It's Raining Men," and
oh,
it's
wow,
raining them, and so I love that, and we're excited for that. We're also excited that this year we're going to offer a tea dance and partner with Chaka Khan Hacienda, who is very well known here in Atlanta for producing epic events. And they will be hosting a Chaka Moment in the Park, which will take place Sunday afternoon following the parade. So we're encouraging everyone to go see the parade on Sunday and then stick around in the park and check out a Chaka Moment in the Park, enjoy the dancing and the music. And then we'll close out Sunday with Starlight Cabaret, which is the largest outdoor Pride event in the country.
Mm-hmm.
And has amazing performers, not only from our city, but around the metro area. And we have some national performers who will be taking the stage as well, including our honorary Grand Marshal for this year, Angeria Paris Van Michaels, who is the newly crowned winner of RuPaul's Drag Race All-Stars.
Oh, wow. Awesome.
And an Atlanta native, so it's a homecoming.
Oh, that's going to be beautiful. That's really going to be beautiful. Another event that you all are known to have as well, because I think is how HRC participates on a more detailed level. Are you all still having y'all brunch that y'all have like Sunday before the parade?
Yes. So the HRC will be hosting their brunch.
Okay.
It is not our event, but the HRC is a great community partner. And they will be hosting their brunch this weekend as well.
Okay, cool. Then yeah, because I didn't know which one who was hosting it. I thought HRC was just a sponsor, but it's actually an HRC event in in partnership with you all. Okay, gotcha.
Yes,
gotcha.
And you know, that's one of the beautiful things about the weekend is there are events all over the city. There's something for everyone. And with saying there's something for everyone, I also want to mention our family fun zone, which has grown over the past several years. We have really invested in trying to create a safe space for everyone. So we're thrilled that we get to offer our family fun zone. And this year, we're going to be offering a teen lounge, specifically on Saturday from 3 to 5 p.m. So again, really just trying to make sure that there are safe spaces for everyone in our community. We also offer a recovery meetup for people who might be on different recovery walks and sobriety. We want to encourage that. So that will be offered as well during the weekend.
This is going to be fabulous, you all. Once again, for those people who are looking for anything to do this weekend, you know to be present at the annual Atlanta Pride Festival, which is going to be held, which is held every year at Piedmont Park. And for more information about each detailed event that's going to be taking place throughout the weekend, please visit all of the information that's located at the bottom of your screen, www.atlantapride.org. Anything you want to say in closing?
I want to say thank you for supporting us. Come out and enjoy the festival. Remember that it's free. And in order for us to keep Pride free, we need your support. So if you visit this weekend, make a donation. If you can't visit, make a donation on our website. But I look forward to seeing everyone in the park. And if you see me, say hello.
Yes, and we're going to be there as well, because I know this. We normally participate in the parade, but I know we're going to skip the parade and just kind of be like the rest of the people this year. But we'll still be getting our media coverage as always and participating in the VIP area and stuff like that. So you look to see Meak Productions out there in the park as well as on the side celebrating as y'all come down the parade. That's going to be awesome. So once again, thank you all so much for being a part of our 15th anniversary episode of Meak Pro Media Special Edition News. Steve, thank you so much. I love you.
Love you. Thank you for having me.
We look forward to seeing you all this weekend. And for those people who can't make it, we hope to hear from you and see you real soon. Take care.